Hello friends, welcome to Meliora Paralegal. Today in this video, I am going to discuss about the procedure of judge's impeachment. The Constitution of India specifies that a judge of the Supreme Court or High Court cannot be removed from his office except by an order of the President passed after an address by each House of Parliament in the prescribed manner. Likewise, the Constitution of India defines certain provisions for the removal of judge from his office and regulation of the procedure thereof. However, the detailed procedure of the judge's removal are given in the Judge Inquiry Act 1968. So, in this video, I will discuss the procedure of removal of a justice of the Supreme Court or High Court. Let's start with the first question. That is, what are the grounds and method that Constitution defines on which a judge of the high judiciary can be removed? As Clause 4 of Article 124 of the Indian Constitution defines, a judge of the Supreme Court shall not be removed from his office except by an order of the President passed after an address by each House of the Parliament supported by a majority of total membership of that House and by a majority of not less than 2/3 of the members of that House present and voting has been presented to the President in the same session for such removal on the ground of proved misbehavior or incapacity. Now check out what this definition says. A judge of the Supreme Court shall be removed only by an order of President. It should be after presentation of an address by each House of Parliament. The address should be supported by a special majority. The address should be presented to the President in the same session and removal has to be on the grounds of proved misbehavior or incapacity. Now, let's check out the procedure defines in the Judge Inquiry Act 1968. The following steps define the procedure. An impeachment motion against the judge of the Supreme Court or a High Court can be initiated in either of the House of Parliament, that is either in the Lok Sabha or Lower House or Rajya Sabha or Upper House. Such motion must be supported and duly signed by minimum 100 members. If it is initiated in Lok Sabha, however, if it is initiated in Rajya Sabha, then 50 members' signature required. After signed by the minimum required members of Parliament, the petition needs to be submitted to Speaker of Lok Sabha. If it is initiated in Lok Sabha, however, if it is initiated in Rajya Sabha, then Vice President, who is by default chairman of Rajya Sabha. Now, you might have the question, that is, what will happen after the submission of such motion in Parliament? The Speaker or, as the case may be, the chairman may, after consulting such person, if any, as he thinks fit and after considering such materials, if any as may be available to him, either admit the motion or refuse to admit the same. However, if the motion is admitted, the Speaker or, as the case may be, the Chairman shall keep the motion pending and constitute as soon as may be for the purpose of making an investigation into the grounds on which the removal of a judge is prayed for. For the investigation purpose, Speaker or chairman shall constitute a committee. Next question you might have: who will be the members of such committee? The committee consists of 3 members, of whom one shall be chosen for among the Chief Justice and other judges of the Supreme Court. One shall be chosen from among the Chief Justice of the High Court, and one shall be a person who is, in the opinion of the Speaker or, as the case may be, the Chairman, a distinguished jurist. Now the next question is: what is the major function of such committee? The committee shall frame definite charges against the judge on the basis of which the investigation is proposed to be held. Such charges, together with a statement of the grounds on which each such charge is based, shall be communicated to the judge, and he shall be given a reasonable opportunity of presenting a written statement of defense within such time as may be specified in this behalf by the committee. Now let's discuss the report of the committee. At the conclusion of the investigation, the committee shall submit its report to the Speaker or, as the case may be, to the Chairman, or, where the committee has been constituted jointly by the Speaker and the Chairman, to both of them, stating therein its finding on each of the charges separately, with such observation on the whole case as it thinks fit. The Speaker of the Chairman, or where the committee has been constituted jointly by the Speaker and the Chairman, both of them shall couch the report submitted under the provision to be laid as soon as may be, respectively, before the House of the People and the Council of States. Next question is: what is the power of committee? The committee shall have power to regulate its own procedure in making the investigation, and shall given a reasonable opportunity to the judge of cross-examining, and the committee shall have power of regulating its own procedure in making the investigation, and shall give a reasonable opportunity to the judge of cross-examining witness, adducing evidence and being heard in his defense. Now, you might have the question, that is, what will happen next? Now, following are 2 possibilities, that is, the committee finds judge is not guilty, or the committee finds judge is guilty. Let's discuss each possibility in brief. The committee finds judge is not guilty. If the report of the committee contains a finding that the judge is not guilty of any misbehavior or does not suffer from any incapacity, then no further step shall be taken in either House of Parliament. But in case the committee finds judge is guilty, if the report of the committee contains a finding that the judge is guilty of any misbehavior or suffers from any incapacity, then the motion referred to in the provision shall, together with the report of the committee, be taken up for consideration by the House or the Houses of Parliament in which it is pending. Now, what will next? If the motion is adopted by each House of Parliament in accordance with the provision of Clause 4 of Article 124, or, as the case may be, in accordance with the clause read with Article 218 of the Constitution, then the misbehavior or incapacity of the judge shall be deemed to have been proved, and an address praying for the removal of judge shall be presented in the prescribed manner to the president by each House of Parliament in the same session in which the motion has been adopted.